Hello everyone, I'm back in Subnautica again as usual. We've had some somewhat big updates, a lot of little minor ones, as well as some weird bugs I like to report. And of course the doors, I'll show you a really fun bug with this door. I've reported it over in Trello. What it'll do is it'll slam you into this wall or all the way up here, and in the process it just spins or raises or lifts or all type of things your sub. But the big thing right now is the new workbench. Get my builder tool, which is now in your builder menu right up here at the top right there. It says it needs 2 titanium, a wiring kit, and a computer chip to build. Of course I have no cost on, so it doesn't matter to me. Now, I did this video a little while ago, tossed it out, because I want to streamline it a little bit, cut down some of the chafe, but also, right after I did the video, they sent out another update, and in the process, they added some animation. Now, remember in the past, I was wondering, what are these things on the corner right here? They're lasers, just like the ones up here on top of the fabricator. Oh, what's going on there? That's weird. But if you click on the workbench here, you now have, as I showed before, you have the different options. None of them work right now. Not a single one. I mean, they fixed the knives now. Here, I'll make one. I'll show you. There's the animation. You see, it doesn't have lasers or anything being built on the table just yet. Zero life size. That's coming. Detected. Lethal radiation levels detected. Just like the fabricator, when you back away, it lowers back down. The primary dark matter containment field has dropped to 36%. So if you notice, here's my normal knife. Continuing to monitor. I'll put that at 1. Here's my heat blade. Same thing, doesn't look any different. So they're both the new knives are not activated just yet. Same with the flippers. I tried them a little while ago, using the UltraClide, and they don't show up on your feet. This is like when you put on flippers down the water, you notice how my feet aren't there. I'll go outside and need to show you anyway. And the doors here. It doesn't matter. These doors, actually, they'll all knock you around, but see, you're underwater. See the flippers there? They don't show when you put on the new UltraClide or the swim charge fins. And those are not working either. They're supposed to, like, say you're using your sea glide here, and as you're swimming, it's supposed to keep it at 100% because it's always charging. That's what they do, but they don't. I swam around with it, and they just kept going further and further down in energy charge. Oh, no, you don't. Where'd you go? Come here, you. Come on. I can't get him. Why? It's weird. Usually I can pick him up. Come on, grab him. Weird. I can't get a hold of him. And I can't get my sea glide to get away from him. If I can get out of his visual range, he'll leave me alone. And the next thing is, get it in my hand, is the propulsion cannon. This is fun, although it still has a bunch of bugs, which I've reported last night on Trello. I went everywhere with this thing, trying to find every little bug I can think of that could happen with it. It's like right now, what's going on?
Emergency.
Oh,
10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Forgot to put on air. Oh boy. I thought I fixed that when I came in. Well, it's fixed now. Okay. The previous oxygen tanks, you notice that my O2 is now at 105. They used to be 100. If you build 2 oxygen tanks and put them in your inventory, you go up to 100. Now it's 105, oddly. Not sure why, but hey, that's cool. Are they asleep? It looks like their eyes are closed. They are. They're sleeping pretty early. Yeah, they're See, the peeper's eyes close now when it gets evening and into the night. The only issue, and I've reported it so that the devs know about it, and they're like, what? Really? Is that they continue to swim about like they normally would with their eyes open. If you look at any documentaries of fish underwater, when they those that do sleep, they pretty much are stationary and rarely move, maybe just a few inches here and there, you know, just to keep the flow going. But they don't swim like they do during the daytime. See, those two are... See, now they're just... basically right there. See, he's doing what he should do at all times, just staying stationary. But if you move toward them, they act like they know you're there, like their eyes are open. That wouldn't happen. You can usually sneak right up on a sleeping fish, and they wouldn't even know you're there. Let's see here. There it goes. If you pick up a bladder fish, they don't stay right in front of your cannon like any other object. They just rotate around. Actually, I need to get a picture of that. Let's see. There. They've added a new animation to the end of the gun. When you launch something, you'll see... let me turn off that so you can see. You'll see it create a ball of electricity. See that? That's pretty cool. The only reason I'm letting it get dark is I want the ship to explode naturally. Although night and day around here is pretty quick, so it should be getting bright again real soon. Now, one of the odd things about the propulsion cannon, and that I found last night when I was playtesting it, is if you move around with it a bunch, if you less than a minute sometimes, let's see if it happens here, the object will be in front of you, and then suddenly it'll vanish. Let's see. Da-da. Come on. Maybe they got it. Maybe they fixed in the update I just got. Doubt it. Mm-hmm. Nope, there it went. See? Just vanished. Okay, what happens is it's still there. What if it literally freezes in the environment where it fell? Where it lost grasp from the propulsion cannon. But the sometimes, like this one here, it keeps wanting to fade out when you get up close to it. It's still there. What's even odder is, it's like right here. There, see it? It just blinks in and out of existence. What? Go away. Not in your territory. So, can I see it from above? Oh, darn. Get rid of it. There it is. Yep, there he goes. Blink, blink. And it'll happen with any object. Will you bug off? Bug off. Bug off. You can pick up any object with it. And sometimes they'll freeze in the environment and not disappear, as you saw. Like, see, it goes away. But if I swim a certain distance away, it should, or at a different angle. Let's see where it appears again. There it is. And bink, bink. If I can't get up close to it at a certain angle. Yeah, right. Ooh, no. Usually it doesn't. Last time I was in here, they didn't totally disappear. I was able to come up to them. They'd be phantoms. You could swim through them, but they wouldn't blink out like that. This will happen with fish, too. If you pick up a fish like this... okay, I'm using my right mouse button to pick something up. Your left mouse button will put the fish in the inventory. But if you go into your inventory and drop the fish, they stay frozen in the environment, and they're phantoms. You can swim right through them. But if you go far enough away that they will vanish from FOV, let's see if he's back to normal here. No, he's still normal. Sometimes, if you go out of field of view, they'll become solid again, and you can pick them up with the terraformer or your hand, but not all the time. He's permanently stuck like that, and that happens with any fish. I tried every fish I can think of. I could come across Oculus, Bleeder. I didn't try the Bleeders, but you can throw those as well. But Oculus, II, Peepers, Boomerang, like here, every fish does the same thing. If you pick it up with the gun, put it in your inventory, and then drop them from the inventory, they freeze. Now, if you put them in your quick launch bar and then drop them, like say, now if you go in here and like put in your first slot here, so it's in your hand, you let them go, then they work fine. Although he's swimming away really strangely. What the hell? He's swimming sideways. He's still swimming sideways. Okay, well, there's a slight bug with him with that. Let's try this again with a different fish so we see what happens. Come here, Gary. Oh, what? He's in my hand, but he's not. Okay, that was weird. Just let him go. Okay, he acts normal. Let's try... Is there a peeper? There's a peeper. Yep. That's... Okay, that's odd. Yeah, the peeper acts sort of normal. Huh. I never tried that bug. I wonder... Well, I launched you. He's like, hello, bye! Okay. And go. Oh, he swam away normal. Okay, I'll have to report that on Trello. That's weird how it's... If you have an empty slot, and the fish will... appear in your first slot, but not in your hand. But your hand's acting like it's holding it. But even with the bugs, and occasionally the gun will act wonky. It'll sometimes appear in an upward angle in your hand, and your hands are not holding it. But that'll be worked on. I think I've had to make 3 new games today just to, fix the issues that happen. Keeps screwing up the saves. Another reason why I don't create big bases, because I'm always making new saves. That's the thing with being in experimental. You can even pick up these fans too, which is pretty cool. I'm so hot. Boom. Ooh, that was cool. Looked like a wing. I actually had it laying down when it launched. I don't want you. Go away. Yeah, there we go. Let's see if I can make it lay down again. There we go, there we go. Cool! I like these rocks right here. Let's see if I can get it. Oh, I haven't tried a crinoid. Oh yeah, that's pretty neat. Now it should be... Oh, it did... Yeah, there, see? No? Wait a minute, I haven't showed you that. Grab one of these. Now, if you launch one, and... Wait a minute. Try this again. It's got to be at a... Okay, I think it just went out of range. Let's see if it's where I think it is. No? There's a weird bug. Let me try it with one, a mushroom. It'll be easier. Okay, let's see if it's where I think it is. I don't see it. Maybe they fixed it in this recent update I just got. That'd be nice. A lot of times if you launch something, and as soon as it leaves FOV, your field of view, it'll lock. It'll right where in the arc where it disappeared. And, it's gone. See if it's still doing it. They might have. Yeah, I think they fixed it. Hey, good. I'm glad I recorded that. Good. Well, at least that one's out of the way. There's all type of fun things you can do with the propulsion can. There's still got a wonky animation here, which I did do a Trello post on. See, if you do, when you change weapons, watch how he twists to the right and then has rubber arms as he bends it around. It's really weird. Actually, I noticed that with the bleeders. Let's see if I can grab them this time. Come here, you little bugger. I can't pick them up. That's weird. And I can't. Am I out of batteries already? Shoot. I need to get away from him. This thing will not stop chasing you. Unless you get out of their point of their field of view. Well, let me go back over to the sub. I want to show you this fun thing. If I can get over. Seems like after playing a while, the game starts getting really laggy. I'm not sure why. It'll be smooth for maybe an hour or so. Hour and a half. I haven't really timed it. But then it'll just become this serious lag fest. I know it's not my computer because it's certain zones. I mean, I can swim around and I can literally go out of the lag and then move away and then suddenly I'm back in it. But right now everything's nice and smooth the way it's supposed to be. Right. Go up here.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Oh, darn, I should have went in here. Did it blow up? I can't remember. I don't think it did yet. It was something at night I wanted to point out. But this door, this is fun. See, if you close the door, there's this bug about how it knocks you around. Now, I actually managed to find how you can steer the sub with the sucker. If you stand in front of it and let it slam you into the wall, it'll cause the sub to go up into the air. Not sure why. If you jump and let it hit you, it'll send you to the side. If you let it slam you into the wall and just stay there, it'll start pulling you into the door, into this right here, and as it's doing so, it causes the sub to speed up really fast, then suddenly it stops. And I'll show you. Look at that. Knocks you backwards. Knocks you up and backwards. Now if you let's see. Going up again. Okay, this time I wanna see if I can make it still going up. Oh, darn it. I want to get into the spot where I can. It'll stay on me. There. Oh, almost had it. So usually it'll. Ooh, what happened there? If you do a jump hit, it sends you sideways, as you can see there. Now it's pushing me. Well, it wasn't. Really wanted to push into me. Oh, almost had it. Nope. Darn it. Come on. Oh, I want the speed up. It's not grabbing me the way it's supposed to. Yeah, it keeps knocking me instead of pulling into me. Let me see if I can push into it. Woohoo! You can can actually do it from this side too. It doesn't. That one doesn't do it as much. Let's see. Check it. Oh, it knocked me forward. That was weird. I also found if you run into it, you get something worse. Oh, that one didn't work. Wait a minute. I need a good running speed. Whoa, there we go, there we go, there we go. Oh, knock backwards. And up. That's what I wanted to see. Okay, let's try this again. Okay, top side again. Woo, I got airborne. A little bit. There, there. Oh, it almost... Oh, there, there. It's still holding me. It's still holding me. I'm spinning faster, faster, faster. Oh, there we go, there we go. See, that's what I was trying to... It starts pulling you into the door there. Wow. Okay. All right. This is going to be... Ugh. There we go. Righted myself. Whoa! Ho-ho-ho! That was interesting. Okay. Oh! I just killed a fish. I heard that. Who died out here? Somebody died. I saw him hit the window. I saw a little blood splatter. Darn it. Come on. There, 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 there. There, come on, come on. Pull me in, pull me in. Aw. Darn it. Come on, pull me into the door so I can speed up. There, there, there. Oh, so close. Oh, it's slamming into the ground, though. Yeah, 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 yeah. Ugh. Oh. Come on. There we go. Oh, oh. Oh, I just killed two fish. Or hurt them, at least. There. Ah. If it wasn't for that sandbank that I just slammed into, I would have continued to speed up. As long as you're in open water. There it goes. There it goes. I'm going faster, 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 faster. Ugh. That was pretty good. I heard two fish get killed. Oh, good. It's almost nighttime. I can show you these things. I'll continue playing until it gets nighttime. Come on. Oh, yeah, yeah. Speed up, speed up, speed up. Oh! Actually, let's move out into the deep water. That way I won't keep hitting.
Readings from the Aurora exhibit characteristics consistent with total degradation of the dark matter containment field. Spikes in quantum fluctuations suggest an uncontrolled cascade detonation.
Now I should be able to speed up.
Probability of 83.5%.
Okay, there we go, there we go, there. Oh, what the heck did I hit? Oh, it knocked me. That's what. I didn't hit something. So I found, this is how you do it. You jump and grab the door at the same time. Yeah, you get at a certain angle, and it knocks you into the wall or something right here, and it stops the flow. You can actually do the same thing while it's spinning. Here, I'll show you. Jump. While it's spinning, if you jump, it stops it. It's a fun glitch, though. I like it, but it's not something that should happen. Ow! Darn it. Oops. Gotta stand right here and jump. Oh, 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 getting a good spin. Got a good spin. Go, go, go. Oh, yeah. That was awesome. Wow. I actually got airborne there. Yeah, because what it does is when you jump... Ooh, what am I standing on right here? I keep... humping over something right here. Something invisible. Right there. There's one on each side of the door right here. Where is it? Yeah, right there. But the reason for it to jump, you have to make it yourself jump so you'll phase into that thing right there when it opens up. Oh, I hit something outside. Yeah, I'm packing the shallows. Man, that thing spun me all the way into the shallows that quick. Okay. Oh, well, it's not totally dark yet. Hold on a second.
Go down, son. Go down.
Son, you better go down. I'm telling you right now, man. Sun went down. Alright. At nighttime, there's this weird bug that concerns clear objects. This light, this panel up here. What was that? A certain angle or something. Oh, look at that. Look at the top of the fabricator. Suddenly became clear. Take a picture of that. Do a collage for the devs on that one. The locker, this door frame. I think these objects right here, and the feet on the that there, the analyzers, your hull plate, the window frames here. Let's see what else. The sea moth. I think the base of, these objects here on the wall, this tube, the base, the upgrade console, I think that was it. Maybe I want to try something here. Boom. Did it move me? It moved me a little bit. And that's about it. But all of those objects become black at night. It doesn't make any sense. Now the sea moth used to be purely black at night. They've fixed that a little bit. They've added this better sheen to it, so it doesn't do it. It's only on the top, the cabin and such. Already sunrise. Actually, wait, I thought that was sunset over there. let's see what else is there. Oh, that's what I wanted to test. Hold on a second. Let's try. Yep, okay. Yeah, there's a bug with the fabricator in the Cyclops. The one that's in the life pod works absolutely perfectly. You see all the animations. But if you build, when you build a fabricator in your Cyclops in here, all the animations are missing. They used to be working, except for a few that still oddly were missing their building animations. But now, for some reason, it's not doing it. They're not showing it any at all. What did I build? Oh, it was those fins. Don't need those. Oh, that should be interesting. Let's watch this. As the sun rises, see this come back into color again. I haven't even watched that. See how bright is it outside? Yeah, that's got blue feet. Actually, everything's sort of back to normal. Right, where's the sun? It hasn't totally come up yet. But see, this is back to normal, and this is back to the way it looks. So this is actually already dark. I forgot about that, but it goes pitch black at night. Sea moth top is back to normal. I didn't check the engine. I want to see that. Yeah, see, it's a dark gray, dark silver instead of black. Tube up here is normal, but it does get a little black at nighttime. These are gray, not black. That's back to normal. These are two. hull plate. Yep, it looks nice and silver again. So there's a weird color change at nighttime. Not a big deal, but still, it's something you see and go, huh? I mean, I just point these things out for the devs, that's all. And I gotta do more on Trello. I need to take these pictures and put them up on Trello so they'll see that. I'll do it from this video, since I've already recorded it. I'm surprised the sun's not up yet. Well, let's play. What? Right before I close out, let's play again. And spinning! Boom. I like spinning. Oh, wait, now I want to do that.
Emergency. Readings from the aurora.
Oh, I haven't blown the aurora yet.
Instability in the primary drive.
Whoa! Core.
The central dark matter reactor will reach a supercritical state.
In
T minus. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4.
Oh, sorry, good. I'm aimed right at it.
2, 1!
Blow up! It go boom! Big time. I did make mention in a Trello post that, if you're underwater, you can actually see it right now. There's this big disturbance in the ocean right now. A shockwave that passes through the environment. Nothing is disturbed by that shockwave. No fauna, no creatures, not even your character. And such a strong forceful wave that races through the environment should push things around and knock fish backwards and your character as well. Just for a little ways. This way or that way. I can see why it wasn't implemented, at least not yet, because they'd have to make animation for the blast wave for each creature, each plant, and so forth. So that's a slightly big undertaking, but hopefully in the future it'll cause a visual push in the environment, knocking fish and plants and animals around and yourself. That would be really cool to see. Well, that's it for now. Not much else at the moment. Each update brings more goodies, and we got a lot of goodies coming our way. Mainly animals. And, of course, I mentioned before, the glass corridors for the bases. Those are going to be fun to play with. And hopefully, very soon, if the devs get working on it. I haven't seen Fox 3D over on the sketch pad make any three-dimensional mock-ups yet, but I really do hope that he creates some vertical modules with ladders in them, so we can create little tall tunnels from base module to base module. So you can put one module on top surface of your area and then dig down real deep into the ground and create another base. So you can just climb down to it. That'd be really cool. Oh yeah, there is something I forgot to do. Somebody requested something in one of my videos. Ooh, that's a good bounce. Come on. Alright, give me a sea moth. Spam. Alright. Somebody wanted to see the... Come on. Somebody wanted to see the interior of... a jelly shroom. So let me find a jelly shroom cave. Is there one down here? Look. Maybe I can get... Let's see if there's one down here. Ah, I see glow. Yes, there we go. Didn't have to go down into deep caves after all. So here's the inside right here. See, it's just a little tunnel. Nothing big about it. But of course, this will not be... You won't be able to go in there once the crab snake takes root within them. because that's where they will be living. So you're not going to want to go in those. It's not like you're going to be able to get anything out of them anyway. Although I think they did something about getting some
caution.
Loot.
Readings from the aurora suggest erratic fluctuations in the primary dark matter containment field. A breach of the main drive chamber may cause a cascading quantum flux detonation.
What was that? And a flash. Let's see. Let's go back to my HUD here so I can see where my sub is. There it is. Over here, over here. Alright. Pause. Now, we did have an update just a little while ago while we were doing some playtesting. 2-hour playtest session. And even though you can't, all the items in the workbench here, you know, these are not working, none of them are, I can show you at least what the heat blade looks like, even though it doesn't work. Where is it? Okay, there's the heat blade. Looks just like the other knife, but it has that orange edging around it, so you can tell the difference. Oh, listen. It's got a sound effect. Cool. Let's go see. What it does is it's supposed to cauterize, cook your food for you. I mean, oh. The only problem is right now when you're using it, you see the stuttering it causes? It's, you can't really move with it. Let's see. Oh, quit. Bug off. Fuck off. Doesn't seem to hurt him much. I want to see what it would do if I got 2-hour fish here. If I can make it. It's still got so much bugs going on with it, it ain't really worth playing with. Once they fix that little lag that happens while you're swimming around with it, then it'll be a good blade. Doesn't seem to do much damage against a stalker, though. So, for now, I'll just put it away. Dink. And I don't remember picking up a creeper vine. I must have sliced it by accident. One of the cool things that happened while we were doing this play test session is, here, let me go move out of this zone. I'll show you. It's just a little thing. I'll head back over to the pod over here. So I get into coral shallows, because that's where I need to be to show you this little. Actually, it should be somewhere right here. I'll pause a second here. Ooh. Okay. Give me my propulsion gun. I need a coral. Let's see, I need some coral shells. Oh, there they are. These guys are right here. These coral shell plates. If you take an acid mushroom and hit it, they do hurt because they release some acid. You'll notice, see it? It just turned white. They didn't even know about that when I showed them. It's like, what? What are you talking about? It actually killed the coral plate. It caused it to change color. They say it's a bug, but I like it. I mean, it shows you that the acid actually is pretty lethal. You can kill carry fishes. They're running around. Peeper. Ooh, got him! missed. Oh, what? Oh, it did the little freeze. You know, we're still working on that. It's been reported how it will sometimes, you know, fall out of your grasp, as I showed. Oh, shoot, I missed. Darn, I need a Gary fish.
Warning, readings from the Aurora exhibit characteristics consistent with
temporal. Come back here, you bugger. Really? That quick? Jeez, that was only 2 seconds.
In quantum fluctuations suggest an uncontrolled cascade detonation will occur with a probability of 83.5%.
But there, I see it watch go white here. No? I might have not hit it properly. Hold on a second. Oh, it broke it. Ah. Bugger. Oh, no. That one might do it. It'll give you an image of them side by side here. See how it turned white and that one's still green? It's a cool effect. Ooh. Try one rabbit ring. Darn it, missed. Oh, nailed him. Rabbit rays are resilient, though. You can. Come here, you. You can slam them into a rock and it won't even hurt them. Look at that. He just is like, eh, that doesn't even hurt. Where'd he go? Where'd he go? Tried that on one of those and see what happens. Nothing? Nothing. Wow, it actually seems to disintegrate before it gets to it. Oh! What? Now that's a new one. It fell out of my hand and fell through the ground. I haven't seen to do that before. Oh, energy. Energy. Yeah. The oxygen must dilute the poison, the acid, before it actually hurts it. Oh, darn. Where'd that rabbit ring go? Oh, there he is. Ooh, nailed him. Oh, shoot. Where'd he go? Oh, froze again. I can't wait till they fix that. Anyway.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Put that away. I'll conclude this video here and hope you enjoyed. I'll see you next time.